What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So we're taking a look at Cyberpunk's newest update with their path tracing technology. And this is really awesome on GeForce Now's ultimate subscription because you have access to the RTX 4080, which will support all the tech you need to be able to run this at a playable frame rate. So let's go ahead and get into it and take a look at what kind of performance we're getting for this and image quality. So you can see for our stream, we are 4K over there and our bitrate stays very good as I have a good internet connection here and input latency as well. We're going to start off in overdrive, but we'll test a few different settings throughout the video. And I'm just going to use presets, even though I would normally tweak things for best performance, just to keep things simple and easy here as we go. And of course, we'll be running the game itself at 4K full screen as well. I'm capping things to 120 because our stream is 120, but we're not going to be playing the game really at 120 FPS anyways. Now, as we get into the benchmark, it's pretty cool because you'll see some of these graphical differences, like the purple color that was in the smoke back there and different areas where the lighting is just more realistic and more natural, among other things, even in this benchmark. Now, I don't like this benchmark for performance so much because it's not always the most accurate thing for that, but it does do a decent job of showing some of our graphical differences that you get with this new path tracing technology and with this more accurate lighting and feel to the overall world here. When we go outside is when I really notice a lot of it because the game has this kind of cool or blue or gray feeling to it without path tracing. But when path tracing is on, you see a much warmer, better image quality here, more like sunlight would look, how the world in general is just a more warm color than it is over without it. And this is one of the bigger things I've noticed since this update that really makes the world just feel better to walk around in and to play in, and it just feels more natural. You can see all the different color variation here as well in the benchmark when we're talking about just that cooler color without the path tracing versus the warmer, and just better color accuracy it feels like as we get into the world. And of course it just looks absolutely amazing, and luckily frame rate does stay playable. I don't think I went under 54 FPS at any point with everything maxed out this way. With some tweaking you could get an even better frame rate or really lock it down to 60, but it looks phenomenal and it's running great here on GFN. Now, if we move in and take a look at some other scenes, I do want to be able to do some comparisons here shortly, but being able to have the population turned all the way up here in the game, plus this path tracing technology and GFN handling all this really well, not just due to the hardware, but over the cloud and streaming to me here, it's pretty impressive. Now, when it comes to combat, I'm not going to get a lot into that. We've gone over Cyberpunk so many times here on the channel, but everything feels just as good and responsive as it normally does when it comes to Cyberpunk on GFN. We get some more frame dips here and there. Of course, depending on where you're at and what you're doing, that will get affected a little bit, but overall, really good. So, I mean, when it comes down to it, there aren't any major changes. We've covered this game a lot and it runs great here on GeForce Now, especially with your 3080 and 4080. With the 4080, we're able to really take advantage of this new path tracing preview tech here in the game, which really makes a difference, especially during the day, like I mentioned, with that more natural lighting. Let's switch over from overdrive here to ultra on ray tracing, and you may not see a lot, but if you look around, especially at the top of the screen where those blue lights are at, there's a big difference there and around the stair reflections and that type of thing. If we go over here to just ultra, of course, turning off all the ray tracing, it makes a big difference. However, Cyberpunk's always been a gorgeous game, and even without RT, it looks great. And you can see how our frame rate's affected as we go through these as well. Of course, the lowest frame rate being the path tracing, but we are pulling that off very well and playable with the DLSS 3 and our DLSS set to auto, which is probably doing performance. Alright guys, I'm going to leave you with some more scenes to check out and some gameplay. Thanks a lot for coming to check out the video as always. I really appreciate it, and I'll see you guys in the next one.
Born and bred in Haven, champion of heaven. future.